In this video, we will talk about some of the cool features which we have in Gmail and which we can use to be more productive and more organized with our emails. So first of all, I would like to introduce this hover action. So there are four things you can straight away do if you go on the right side of any of your emails without selecting the email. So you can, for example, select an email and press the delete button to delete that email. But now in this modern interface, you don't have to select an email. You can straight away go on the right side and delete the email. And similarly, there is another feature which is called archive. So you can archive this email, and I'll talk about this next. And a snooze feature, which we will also discuss today, and what does snooze mean. And similarly, you can also mark this email as unread if you click this. So this, as you see, now this email has been checked already, but if I click this, so it can be marked as unread. So now let's talk about archive. So when you archive an email, for example, if I archive this email, so this email will disappear from your inbox. And where does this email go? This email go into this all mail folder. Google should name this folder as archived, but I don't know why they named this as all mail. So if you click on this folder, so you will see that on the 9th of December, this was probably the email, so which we have archived. If you want to bring this email back, so you can just right click on this and it will show you move to inbox. If you click this, now this email will come back to your inbox. So this is how you archived an email, and the purpose of archive is to make your inbox clean. So if you don't want to read any email but you don't want to delete the email, then you archive that email, so that if in case you want to read that email, you can still go to your in all mail and you can read these emails later if you like. So this is the purpose of archive. And snooze is a very good feature as well. Snooze means that this email will be removed from the inbox and Google will show this email again in the inbox as a fresh email. So if you don't want to reply to an email at the moment, but you want to reply all of these type of emails on, let's say, on Sunday or on any next date, or you have fixed a day for these type of emails, so you can snooze some of your emails in inbox, and then whatever time you tell Google, so Google will show you that email again as a fresh email. So you press snooze and it will show you snooze until. If you straight away want to snooze until tomorrow or later this week, you can select any of these options. And if you want to snooze for a particular date and time, you can click on pick date and time, and then you can select any date and time when you want Google to bring this email back to you as a fresh email so that you can reply. So this is also a very good feature to when you want to organize your emails and when you want to be productive, you want to reply some of your emails urgently while other you want to snooze. And another way to organizing your email is by using these stars. And the next thing which we want to discuss is this star feature. Since we have already discussed this important feature, that if you click on this arrow, Google will think that this email from this sender is important. So I'm not discussing this now. But this star, you can also arrange your emails by using stars of different colors. So as you can see that you have yellow stars at the moment, but you can also select some other colors for these stars. And the way you do it is just go to your settings and then click on settings. And in this general tab, if you scroll down, you will see stars of other colors. So I am currently using only three colors for this star. So for example, if an email contains some question and you want to highlight that email with a question mark, which you want to reply later, so you can select this question for that email. You can just drag this and bring it to in use section and you will be using this star. I will not recommend using all of these, because when you select this star, you have to click one by one. So let me show you how we can do this. So we save changes, go back to now inbox. So the way you select different color, the first color you select is yellow. And if you click on this again, it will show you some other colors like green and then this question mark. So you can select any of these stars, whichever you like. So the next feature we want to discuss is the preview pane. So the way you enable preview pane is by going into settings and then settings again, and then you go to advanced section, advanced tab, and in advanced tab here you can see that preview pane enabled. It is currently disabled. You can just enable this and then you save changes. And now you will notice a difference here, as you can say that now you have this icon here, and if you click on this you can split it in a vertical split, horizontal split, or no split. So currently no split, so we will say vertical split. And now if you click on any of the emails, you will see the preview of that email here. Any email, if you click, you will see the preview of the email on the right side of the email. So this is the preview pane which you can use if you want to quickly have a look at your emails. So I would recommend the vertical span, but you can also span it horizontally. So the last thing I want to show you is the display setting of Gmail interface. As you can see here that this email has a little bit more white space in between than all other emails. And this is because this email has an attachment. If you click on this wheel and there is a display density icon. So if you click on display density, so we are using default display density. So there is another available which is called comfortable and a compact. So in default, you can see the attachment. So you can see if the email has an attachment, you will see it here, and therefore this email will be a little wider. And while if you use any other, for example, if you use this comfortable and you select OK, now as you can see that you don't see the attachments. All the emails are having the same width. And if you want to use the compact one, press OK, you will see that now you have a lot more emails in your display than the comfortable or the default one. Whatever display you like, you can arrange one of these displays. I normally like this comfortable. I don't like the default one, and I don't want to see the attachments with my email. So therefore I like this comfortable one. So these were some of the cool features which we have in Gmail. So I hope that you can use these features to be more organized and more productive with your email.